Hi, and welcome to this What's New session for cross-environment intercompany postings. My name is Brian Nielsen, and I'm a program manager with the Business Central team. And with me, I have my colleague.
My name is Jose Antonio Garcia, and I'm a developer in Business Central.
What we will do in this session is take you through intercompany postings, just a brief recap of what it is and what we did in the last release, where we did a few new features. Then we'll see a demo of the new capability for doing intercompany across environments. That will be Jose who will do that. And he will also take you through the setup that you need to get it working. And then he also has a few tips and tricks. So let's look into intercompany. Intercompany is for when you're doing interactions, transactions between group companies, like you all belong to a group of a business. And sometimes the subsidiary sell to other subsidiaries, or you buy all from a common production environment. And you can use intercompany to do that. It sets up your partners as intercompany partners. It has a feature where you do mapping of dimensions and chart of accounts. It can support multi-currency. They don't all have to be the same currency. They don't all have to be the same dimensions, and they don't all have to be the same chart of accounts. So it's very flexible in the setup that it supports. It works through sales and purchase documents, and it also works through general journals. But let's just take a brief look at what we did in the previous release. We made a one-stop shop for the setup, so it's easier to see the different parts. We added some cues on the fact box, so you can see what's maybe missing in your setup. We did some mapping side by side. We did a synchronization, so you don't have to handle files when you import an intercompany chart of accounts or the dimensions. We improved the navigations going to and from the different in and out boxes, so it's easier, at least in the setup phase and in the troubleshooting phase. That helps a lot. We added the ability to do bank-to-bank transactions in general journals. You now also have the comments in the journal transactions and in the document transactions. And lastly, we made it possible that even if you accepted an intercompany transaction, you can go to that document and still reject it. So we made intercompany a lot easier to work with. So let's just look at where are we in terms of features before we start with the new parts. So I have an intercompany setup. In this business, I have a holding company or my parent company, and I have two subsidiaries. And I've set them up as IC partners, and I have a few parameters. For each of them, I specify what they're called, where they are, what if they're using a currency code, and if I want to auto-accept transactions coming from them. And I can also, I just turn on the edit, I can match them with a customer, and I can also match them with a vendor, so I can use the customer and vendor capabilities we have in the product. And for the bank-to-bank, I can also set up bank accounts. For each of the companies, you need to have a mapping to your chart of accounts. So you can import a common chart of accounts, and then you do mapping for that. And that is what we built last time. We did it side by side. For one is the incoming part, like when you receive something, where do you want to map it to? And one, if you send something out for like a set of accounts or one account, which IC chart of account do you want to map it to? So that you can have different chart of accounts in the companies that you do intercompany with. The same goes for dimensions, where we also set up a side-by-side mapping, so it's easier to manage. But that's basically it. In this company, I have only set up same environment. They are in the same US environment that I have. So for this release, we have also introduced the capability to allow IC partners that reside in a different environment. And Jose will first show you an example of does it work? And after that, he will show how it's set up.
Yeah, thank you, Brian. So here you can see basically side by side two different companies. The one on the left is on, let's say, tenant one, and the one on the right is in tenant two. So they are completely different. They belong to different business entities, but in reality, they are just one big company. So let's try it out. Before, if you wanted to work with Intercompany across tenants or across environments, you will need to download some documents and move those. To avoid some manual errors that could occur during that time, we decided to allow Intercompany to work across companies. So in this scenario, I have this customer linked to this company B. But for me, internally in company A, it's just another customer. Let's say that I want to assign some desks, and I get, let's say, 55. Yep. Right now, if I post this, we will be internally handling a normal sales invoice, and at the end of the process, we will be sending this information to company B. This part has been done before through Intercompany. However, now across environments, we allow it to work basically as an abstraction for the user. They don't know that the customer that they're interacting is in a completely different tenant. So now if we go and refresh the company B, we will be able to see that in the Intercompany inbox, we will have a new entry. Yeah, so if we go scroll down, here we will have our queues. And if we go into the details, we'll have a purchase document with a different information and the quantity, and then we can accept as usual. For anyone who is familiar with Intercompany, there hasn't been that much of change. The idea is that we wanted to make it seamless for anyone working with Intercompany to do these transactions across environments. All the existing functionality for Intercompany is now supported cross-environment. Cross-environment means that it could be handled with two different environments in one tenant or across tenants, but you need to do some setup. And we can jump into it right now. I have here in tenant two, I have a new company that I want to set up with my company A in tenant one. So what we will need to do is go into the Intercompany setup in both companies, and we just add a new IC partner. There is a new action that will help us to establish this setup, and we can basically do it both in parallel, but this information will need to be shared across businesses. So if we, one thing, since this is a new company, you will need to give it a unique name, IC new, for example. And then we need to create a reference to this other company and then connect. The connect will give us a wizard. We will need to accept the conditions because our data might be switched across geos, and there are some privacies that you will need to be aware of before moving forward. And the setup is analogously in both parts. First, we will need to know where do you want to reach out. For that information, to make it easy, we provided your company information that you will need to share with any other Intercompany partner that you want to interact. So for example, we will copy these four entries that we see up here. So you can see the Intercompany ID needs to be the same, so I don't need to paste it again. And we will do the same backwards. Once we know where do we want to reach out, we will need to authenticate. In order to generate this information, you will need to have a Microsoft Entra ID registration application. I will give more details later on. But yeah, so now you can see I have filled in all the different fields. And then before we move forward, we will do a test connection to verify that these details were correct. If everything goes well, you will see this message that allows you to move forward and save this as a new Intercompany partner. From this point onward, it will be what Brian mentioned. You can basically establish the currency. We will pick up the one that is used by default by the other company. In this case, they are using the same one, so that's why you don't see a difference. And you can attach it to a customer and vendor and have the existing functionality for these two parts. As a small test, you can also, for example, copy the bank accounts that the intercompany partner allowed for usage across intercompany, and you will have them show up to you. That's basically all for the intercompany setup. From this point onward, you will not know that you are working with an intercompany partner in a different tenant. However, there are a couple of tips and tricks that I think that will be beneficial for you guys to know. First of all is the authentication details. These authentication details that you see at the very bottom need to be created in Azure as a normal app registration. There is more information on how to do this in our documentation. However, you can, at the end of the process, you will need to create a new Microsoft Entra application where you will introduce the client ID, descriptive name, and you enable it. And once you have enabled it, you need to assign it this permission set that is cross-environment API, cross-environment intercompany. This will allow you to basically send and receive communications and allow other companies to log in into your system for working with intercompany. Due to some security requirements, we had to remove the ability to insert this kind of new intercompany partners because you will be able to reach out without limits. So by default, only admins have that permission, but if you want to assign it to any user, you just need to go into the permission set and assign it this permission set, create and modify intercompany partners. Another tip that we discovered during our testing is that in some situations, companies that are across tenant and across environments might be in two different regions, and they don't have the currencies enabled that will allow them to communicate with them. So make sure that if you're talking with an intercompany partner that is using a different currency than you are, make sure that you have it on the list of currencies locally. Also, on a more technical details, these cross-environment communications are handled by job queues. As you can see in the partner, for example, on the left, the one that sent the transactions, you will be able to see in the logs that there was a send notification and a cleanup notification. The sending information will be done in the name of the user that started the transaction, while from that point onwards, the intercompany partner that you created through the Microsoft Entra registration will handle it. And I think that's basically everything to get started. Going back to you, Brian.
Yeah, and maybe it's important to note, because you say you need to create an app, like the registration app.
Yes.
But you don't need to be a developer for that. It's basically just a record in the Azure portal and a few clicks following the manual, and you're done.
Yeah. And just a small detail, for those of you that don't need to work across tenants, this registration app can be used for all environments within one tenant. So it's true that in this scenario, we had to use two registration apps, but that's only because we are working in two different tenants. If you are working in only one tenant, one registration app will allow you to use intercompany.
So I set up one app for my company.
Yes.
And I can use it for all my partners.
Exactly.
But I still need to do the setup for each of the partners.
Exactly.
To identify them.
But the good thing is that once you do the setup for Microsoft Entra, that will be enabled for all the companies on that environment. You don't need to do it per company. Just it's once per environment.
Yeah. Super. Thank you, Jose. So with this, we hope that you will use intercompany postings more than you already are. Now that you have these new capabilities to do intercompany cross-environment. Thanks for joining this session.